Do you think that the members of the Proud Boys, now I know they're not a real group, but they are just a fraternal order.
The ANC is not a real group. That's correct.
They're just a fraternal order. Do you think that they sit there and they go, Gavin's really doing it for us, as opposed to like trying to get a show on, on
that'd be a question I'd be asking.
What was that? What's that men's
Spike TV?
Yeah, Spike. Yeah, exactly.
That's
exactly Spike TV. Fuse or whatever.
That was my tweet, right? When that first happened, I was just like, oh, looks like somebody still thinks he can get a reality show.
Right, exactly.
Frowny face. No,
TV producers on the one hand, Proud Boys on the other.
Did you guys see I, Tanya? Did you see the movie with Tanya Hart? That's a great movie.
Yeah.
And the guy who is her boyfriend's or her husband's friends who lives with his parents but claims that he's like
a security
specialist is like a prototype for all of these people that we're dealing
with.
He's the precursor of incels, Proud Boys, alt-right, Trump. So I have to think that that guy's taking Gavin's word for it.
Right. Gavin's really falling on the sword.
Yeah, Gavin's really doing it, but it sucks for him because he can't hang out with us.
Can't hang out, but he's going to be in. You know what? There's going to be it's a bunch of like QAnon style theory. Conspiracy theories, like, flatulence maker on the Reddit thread is actually Gavin, or you know, on Gab.com or whatever it is that they, you know.
You know what's sad about Gavin, though, is that flatulence maker on Reddit might actually really be Gavin.
Yeah, it's true.
I think you guys might be optimistic, because at least when I first saw this video, I looked at the comments and people were like, this is lame. Like, here's a...
That's not optimistic. Maybe they're doing better than we're giving them credit for.
That's what I'm saying. It's too optimistic for his bottom line.
All right, let's put up the comments. Let's do this segment. We'll call this segment, Do the Proud Boys Believe Gavin McInnes is doing this for their benefit?
I have been told it will help the Robben Islanders.
Here we go. We've got our special segment, Gavin Leaves the Proud Boys video. Let's look at this. There's 9,000 comments.
Look at the top comment.
Sargon of Akkad, the Proud Boys did nothing wrong. He comes in. Backroad Biker Adventures. The man denounces the alt-right. So who cares what he thinks or has to say? Why am I not surprised that the intellectually dishonest media has once again succeeded in destroying another conservative organization? Connor Anderson, Antifa beats and stabs innocent people for no reason for 3 years and nothing happens. Proud Boys get jumped by Antifa and defend themselves for 30 seconds and attack. You know, we missed a part in this where Gavin says, you know, Proud Boys never show up at Antifa rallies and protest them. Antifa doesn't have rallies because all they're doing is fighting against fascists like yourself.
We should do an official MR Antifa rally.
Don't show up. Don't bother us. It's free speech, motherfucker.
You can't appease a mob, my friend.
Beer-based a dwarf. Controlled opposition is controlled. Well done.
Ooh.
Yeah, you can
thank. I like this one.
Thomas Salazar, you can thank Joe Rogan for some of this backlash, too. He could have backed you up. What a puss. He criticized your outfit on another interview behind your back. Turns out he's just a stupid pothead. MNO Creative 22, extremist group, my foot. The Proud Boys are just doing what some of us, some cops are afraid to do because of fearing for their jobs. Proud Boys are just protecting people who can't fend for themselves. That's not extremist. Thomas, nothing against pot. Joe just can't stand it when people think it makes him smarter. Bovis, Proud Boys still live on. Gavin is saving 9 good men from unfounded political prosecution. So they believe
that's the I, Tanya guy right there.
So wait, so who's saying that this is not... who's saying, never apologize, never surrender. If you do, they win. Clearly, everything the left says is a lie.
That was a common sentiment.
People believe it, Ashley Marie. I hate this. I hate you've been bullied into stepping down. They're not going to go easy on them because you step down. I feel like you stepping down is going to make it worse. This is really bad. Proud Boys, not Proud Soys.
Nice.
No one seems to notice that. There's 9,000 comments.
A fucking soy
but
boy.
No, they all think that that he's just being, this is what it's all just a failure, as opposed to like, hey, wait a second, are you sure this isn't a grift?
Yeah, that's true.
Are you sure you're not just doing this to rehabilitate yourself so that you can get a job, and you've taken this as far as you could go, and now you realize like it's starting to,
well,
it's a net cost to you, that it's not really been an ideology, that it's really just been about like, I'm trying to make money, and I realize like, oh, this is leading to nowhere. I'm losing too many jobs, I'm losing too many friends, my wife is mad, I may have to move or something like that. This isn't about a perspective, it's just really just a scam, and I'm just racist enough not to worry about the implications of it, or misogynist enough, however you feel more comfortable talking about it, whatever it is you think.
There seem to be two type of reactions. One from the type of person that's like, I wouldn't want that heat either, and I would back down. And then the other person is like, lock and load, baby. It's time to defend the Proud Boys.
I think there's somewhere it's just like, you're making the classic mistake. You're giving in to the left.
Or here's the real one, speaking of white nationalism not existing. So what's wrong? So it's wrong to be white and want to preserve your nation? But is it just... Just to be clear, you can be non-white and want to preserve your nation, right? Part of that non-existent thing that he was talking about earlier.
A lot of controlled op McInnes once again defames alt-right conservatives to please his masters in a poetic show of phony surrender to the very deep state, which has employed him as a distraction and a controlled opposition mainstay. Well, I mean, use controlled op in twice in one sentence.
Well, I mean, obviously, Gavin was always a total cock.
It's a bit redundant, the way to put it. Yeah, there we go.
Funneling soy.
Soy funnel.
Fat
bitch.
Guy, no more. Said war on men. Simple.
That's a key takeaway. Yeah.
There you go.
It's the war on men. I could not by the way, that was a very good, very disturbing movie. And as soon as that guy came on screen in the iTanya movie, I just was like, oh my God, this is just
right.
I literally was like reading all of the media landscape that we deal with every day. Like now I have an image for that guy.
Right.
For every single commentator.
Now that guy has the internet.
No,
and
now
he can
that
connect
guy.
With other,
now
other,
he is actually a counterinsurgency
expert. Exactly.
He's actually funneling info to Roger Stone.
He's on Fox.
Yeah.